going to play a game, and this is flash cards.
Yeah.
Okay? So you have to tell Mommy what's on the card. Okay? What's that?
Cow.
It is a cow. What color is this?
A.
The color. Do you know what the color is?
Yeah. It's yellow.
It is yellow. High five. What are these?
Shoes.
Shoes. What's wrong with the little boy? Is he happy or is he sad?
Sad.
He is sad. Yeah. That tears. Sad. Good job.
Yeah.
Do you know what that is?
Yeah. It's a fan.
It's a fan?
Yeah. That's Mommy's fan.
It kind of looks like Mommy's fan. Do you know what this is?
It's an apple.
It is an apple. You're winning. Look how many you won. What's this?
A book.
A book. What's this one?
A hat.
It is a hat. It's a cowboy hat, huh?
Yeah.
What's this?
A fish.
A fish. How about this one?
It's a ninja turtle.
Ninja turtle? This one's just a turtle. But you know what? That's awesome. So that's a turtle. Good job.
Yeah.
What's this one?
It's a dog.
It's a dog? Do you know a dog?
Yeah, it's Mommy's dog.
Mommy's dog? Is this Cody?
Yeah.
It's a dog. You're right.
Yeah.
Do you know what color that is?
It's blue.
It is blue.
Yeah.
What's this?
A car.
A car?
Yeah.
Now, is the dog in the box or out of the box?
He's in the box.
He's in the box. You're winning.
Yeah.
What's this?
A ball.
A ball? You're right.
Yeah.
Which way is the arrow pointing?
That way.
Which way is that way?
That way.
Is that up or down or left or right?
Down.
That one is up. When it's up, up. Up there, up in the sky.
Yeah.
All right. Is the bunny going really slow or really fast?
Really fast.
Really fast. What's this?
A duck.
It is a duck.
Yeah.
Do you know what this is?
It's a tree.
It's a tree. You're doing so good. What's this? Do you know? This one might be hard for you.
It's a cat.
Well, it kind of looks like a cat. This is a fox. Can you say fox?
Fox.
Okay, so this one's a fox, but it kind of looks like a cat, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Do you know what color this is?
It's red.
It is red. You're doing so good. What's this?
A sock.
A sock? Where's the other one? Is there another one?
No.
No, but we wear two socks, don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is this little boy happy or sad?
Happy.
Happy boy.
Yes.
What's that?
It's a star.
That's a star? What's this one? Do you know what that is?
It's a sun.
It's the color of the sun. This one's the moon.
Yeah.
So that's what the moon looks like, but you got the stars. High five. Good job on that.
Mm-hmm.
What's this?
It's...
Do you know what it is?
It's a glove.
A glove?
Yeah.
It is a glove, but we're going to call this one, it's also called a mitten. Can you say mitten?
Mitten.
Yeah, but you're right. It is a glove. It's a mitten. Good job. Is the dog in the box or outside the box?
He's outside at the box and the duck's looking it.
Yes, he is. You are right. He is outside the box.
And he's a dog.
He is a dog.
Yeah.
Do you know what color that is?
Red.
It is red. Is this a girl or a boy?
A boy. He's happy.
He's a happy boy.
Yeah.
Which way is the arrow going? Is the arrow going up or is the arrow going down?
It's going up.
This one? When they point that way?
Yeah, up.
Up is that way and down is this way?
Yeah.
So this arrow is pointing down. Okay? You did really good. What's this?
A star.
It is a star.
Yeah.
What color is this? Do you know?
Green.
It is green. High five. Is this a boy or a girl?
A girl.
Oh,
she's
goodness.
Happy.
And she is very happy. What color? Let's see. Maybe we'll... Do you know what color she's wearing?
Pink. She's wearing pink.
She's wearing pink. What color is this one?
Purple.
Did you know it's the same color as your shirt? You are wearing purple too. Good job. Can you tell me what that is?
It's a baseball.
It's a baseball bat.
Yeah.
So can you say bat?
Bat?
Yep, so that's a baseball bat. Good job.
Bat.
And what color is that?
Green.
Not green. This one is black.
Yeah.
Can you say black?
Black.
All right, so look at this, Ari. You won all of these cards. Look how many you won. Oh my goodness, you know what is on every single one of these. Did you know that?
Yeah, I want to play again.
You want to play again? Okay, we'll play again. But see, remember what color? This is black.
Yeah.
This is a fox.
Yep.
When the arrow goes down, it's pointing like this. And when the arrow goes up, yep, it's pointed up. See, this one's going to the ground. This one's going to the sky. Mommy is so proud of you. High five. Oh, oh, one more time. Knuckle bump. I can't believe how many you got. I'm so excited for you. Good job. We'll play again, okay?
Okay, I'm gonna do it myself.
You wanna do it yourself? Okay, yep. Let's mix them up a little bit and I'll let you do it yourself.
Okay, you wanna watch me play?
I do wanna watch you play. I am so, so proud of that little pumpkin pie right over there, because I cannot believe how many of those things that she got right. And not only that, folks, we have had a fantastic day. That little cutie helped me clean up that room that was full of toys and everything from the past few days. She organized it and made it look good. I'm gonna show you what she did. I'm actually quite impressed with what she did. So this is Aria's toy corner, and it's not perfect, but guys, for a three-year-old, that's pretty darn perfect in putting her toys away. But anyways, what I wanted to tell you guys, because I realized I hadn't said anything. So when I, at the beginning of last week, when I cleared out my ears because it was hurting really bad, my update on that is my ears feel fine. They feel great. Everything is good on that home front. There was at least one more thing that I was going to say, and I can't remember exactly what it was now. Gosh darn it. I can't remember. There was something else I was going to tell you, though. So I remembered what I wanted to talk about, and it was that I got all of my files transferred on my from my solid-state drive to my external hard drive, which is awesome, so now I'm not panicking. I got my shelf put up, and I will give a shelf tour later so I can show you everything that I have put up there. And the last thing I wanted to say is I tried that cafe vanilla stuff for my Keurig, and it is so incredibly sweet. And I don't know if I'm gonna do another one of those or not, but my friend Lori Smith said that she likes to have those over ice. So I'm gonna give that a try, because maybe some of the ice will kind of dissipate some of the sweetness, I don't know. It's a very busy, busy day in the Rumnab household. I have spent part of last night doing lots of planning and some implementing. I have been working on the Drifter Challenge rules once again for updating for the City Living Expansion Pack and for the Vampires Game Pack. I found some little mistakes here and there, so I'm just kind of correcting those as well and getting those all good to go. So I've spent a lot of time doing that, and I'm spending some more time because I'm only on house number 12 and there are 24, so I'm only halfway done. My daughter is currently in the back, and you can probably hear her in the background. She is practicing her flute. On Monday, there is a concert, and she has 6 solos in a total of 2 songs that she's practicing for. It is not raining today, so we have my husband and the 2 boys currently are the ones that are out there in the yard pulling weeds, edging the grass, and trying to make it look really nice. And if I get finished up with my Drifter Challenge rules and that kind of stuff, I'll be heading out there. And if not, the guys have the lawn covered out there. I'm going to watch the kids here in the house, my tiny human, and kind of keep an ear on my other one.
I'm keeping my shoes on.
You're keeping your shoes on because you may go outside, aren't you? Maybe? Yeah, you might be going outside. So she's gonna go outside and hang out with them for a little bit, but if she gets, you know, too much underfoot, then I'll be bringing her back in. But that's our plans for our Saturday. It's kind of a busy, kind of wildish day of all kinds of mismatch of doing things. Daddy is busy working out there. You see that? He's edging so that we can have a nice line. And the boys are all the way out there. You see them, Ari? They're out there doing some weeding and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, look at them so hard at work. Oh my goodness. Look at my boys working so hard out there. Oh, I'm such a proud mommy right now. There's Aria keeping them company. I am going to get right back to this right here, which is all the rules and regulations for the Drifter Challenge. But yeah, they're out there doing stuff, and this is what it looks like right now, and it's going to be a vast improvement when they're finished, so I'm going to kind of keep an eye on stuff and keep you guys posted. There we go, folks. We got the line all ready to go, so it's quite a bit straighter than it was. See, it's been so encroaching or whatever. It's coming over quite a bit, so we wanted to get that shaped up again, because I have plants right about... Well, actually, it's pretty much right there. You can't even see them because they're choked in with the grass right here. But there are plants right there. Mm-hmm. So we're going to get all that grass there dug out. Ty is doing a magnificent job of getting out all of those weeds and everything, all the moss. So it's going to look fabulous. It's still pretty rough right here. We've got lots of divots and stuff. It hasn't been raked out, but guys, that spot where I was saying that all of the grass is just coming up and choking my plants, now we actually have space. These are the plants right here. They're still brown, of course, but it's so much better. We're gonna have so much more room. We still have this whole section. So this is what it used to look like right here, and this is what it looks like now. So we still have that whole section to do. And we plan to obviously get all this all tended nice and everything. But right here, this big bush type thing here, we're gonna kind of shrink it down because there are stuff right behind it, right here, that are getting just swallowed up by this plant. But guys, look at this. I didn't even know we had these right now. I just walked out and saw them. But look at, yay, we have little crocuses. I'm so excited. And then this dead stuff right here, obviously. All that is going to have to go. And every year, this gets pretty tall right here, and we have another one on the other side of the house. And they're really beautiful purple flowers, so we're gonna get that all taken care of. And that's pretty much how our yard looks. I just realized that I hadn't given an update on what the yard looked like after they had been out here for a while. So we have plans to get some soil and some bark dust and put it all down right there so it'll look really, really sleek, and all of the tulips and stuff can come up and it'll look great. I can't wait to do it. After a few hours, I got this all done, and so I kind of wanted to do a little shelf tour and show you everything that I put on here. So this is what it looks like, the final product. People who follow me on Twitter got to see. So here in the top left-hand corner, I have a little jar that says Count Your Blessings. And I actually have some stuff stuffed in there, actually. A couple years ago, I was writing something that happened every single day. And like the highlight or something that is unexpected, and I put it in the blessings jar. And actually, when my mom gave that to me, she actually put in a bunch of little blessings that she wrote as well. So it actually has some stuff in it. And I don't know. I like having it there because it's probably going to remind me that I should add my blessings to it. But that's this one. Right here, I've got the booklet from Sims 4 that I got and a little USB keychain right there. So that's got my Sims stuff in there. I've got my books, the only three that I own of all the books that I would like of hers. This is my favorite author, Sophie Kinsella. And then this one right here is the F-14 Tomcat. It's a Navy jet. And that was my very favorite jet of all time. I absolutely love that jet. Anyways, over here on the wall, we have a family picture of the Ruminab family. I can't remember when we took that picture, but we got this picture frame when we moved into our house. And we actually finished closing on it and the house was ours. The people that we were going through the loan process with, they gave that to us as like a housewarming gift. And then right here is my little section of some video games, which is like Sims, obviously, that's there. There's Sims 1, 2, 3, and 4 all in there. I've got some of my movies that are my favorites, and I also don't want my kids to get into them. So I have The Tudors. I have Dead Angel. There is a game for Final Fantasy X-10-2, which I'm currently playing. I have Top Gun, The Mirror Has Two Faces, Jackie Chan and the Drunken Master, and Beauty and the Beast. And so that's that little collection right here. So this one right here, I have this vase. It's a Fenton glassware. I don't know if anybody knows anything about collectors or anything like that, but Fenton glassware is really nice, very collectory, antique-ish stuff, and it's kind of spendy. And I was working at a mom and pop shop, and I kept eyeballing that vase, and I wanted it so badly, but I could not justify purchase at that price. But when I had my wedding shower, a few of my coworkers pitched in to buy that for me, so I have that really beautiful vase. This picture frame, I plan to put a picture of my cat Princess that passed away a few years ago, and so I just need to get it all printed out, and she'll be there. Down on this one, we have my crown that my husband bought for me for Christmas. So that goes along with royalty and the pineapple quote that Lori Smith kind of showed me, which is, go out there and be a pineapple, stand up tall, wear a crown, and be sweet on the inside. So there's my crown. There's this little dog right here, and that's something that I had gotten from my sister when I was a very little girl, and I have held on to it this entire time. This right here is a really cute statue. I really, really, really like this style. She's holding a little kitty. My mother gave that to me because it was very fitting that it was for me, that was mine. Right over here we have What a Difference a Day Makes, and this is from my in-laws. So the top date is when Will and I got married, and then each of the dates after that are all of my children. So we have that little plaque, which is pretty cool. I've got this little photo album right here on the left, and this one is when I went to Italy. It's the only time I've really been out of country other than going to Canada once before. I went to Italy when I believe I was in 8th grade. I could have been 7th. I can't remember. 7th or 8th grade I went. So I have all of my memories in there, and I've got little tickets, and I've got all kinds of stuff, so it's kind of neat. And right next to it, I have the vacation fund. Now, the vacation fund jar is kind of more just like a, I don't know, kind of a novelty piece. we don't usually go on vacations, but, you know, I would like to take my husband to Italy someday. But that's my little vacation fund jar. In the next one, this is also tied to Italy. I got those two masks right there. I got those when I was in Venice. They had stalls everywhere with these and with little glassware pieces. And so I picked up a bunch of masks, and those are two of my favorites. So they're in there. The picture of Belle, my oldest daughter, Chantel, gave me that. Belle is my favorite princess and has been forever and always. So she has a spot here in this. And my last little bit right here is a memory book that my mother and father put together. And it's a bunch of photos of me growing up. And so they're all in there, and it's actually a really neat book. And so I put it up there so people can take it down if they want to and read it or look at it, whatever. So I've got my memory book. I've got both of these little characters right here. When Will and I were dating, I bought those, and they were kind of these little, you know, one was Amber, one was Will. Aren't we so cute? But they're just like little knickknacks that make me smile, so I still have those. And the very last thing that I have here on my shelf is actually, there's cologne in here, but not very much left anyways. That was my dad's, and it actually, he doesn't use that kind anymore, but when I was a kid, that was like his staple. That's what he smelled like, and I can still smell it a little bit. So I hold on to that because that reminds me of my dad. But anyways, this is everything that's on my shelf. My husband says this reminds him of pretty much me. That's like Amber's shelf. But I got it all together and I'm pretty proud of it. And so yeah, there's my little shelf tour. Here's my homie hanging out, playing video games. There was an update to No Man's Sky, and so he's checking all that out. Everything's like super bright though, isn't it? Whoa, are you doing combat?
Thinking about it.
I didn't know you could do combat. Oh, look at that gamer face. He can't even talk to me at the same time. I'll quit pestering. I'll go see what Aria's up to.
Can't even hit anything, apparently.
Let's see.
I shot that guy like, I tried to shoot him. Let's see.
Yeah, do some cool footage. Show it.
Okay.
I have the camera just right.
Let's see if I can.
Yay! Go get him. You didn't even try. There we go. Yes. That's awesome. I didn't know you could do that. Oh. He's gonna crash. Oh my gosh, you got so close to him. Anyways, you have fun playing the new No Man's Sky updates and everything. Tell me how it goes and if I should play it too. Pumpkin's playing out here, aren't ya? Go have fun. I just love the way these sound. They sound so pretty. It's got a nice little breeze out here today. There's the dog, huh, Cody? Aria's just having fun out here. It's not a super sunny day. It's just kind of overcast, but it's warmish out here, so she's getting a chance to come out in the backyard. I cannot wait till we start doing stuff in the backyard here. We're gonna eventually have underground sprinkler system back here so that it'll look really nice, and we'll put in new grass and everything. So yeah. It should prove to be a fun day, fun week. My mother-in-law is coming up to hang out for a few days. I don't know how long she's staying, but it's always exciting to see her. So she will be up here today. And we also have Chantel's very first meet for track today. And if she can make it over 6'6" on the pole vault, they are probably going to take her down to a meet for varsity down in Medford this weekend. So I will get footage while we're there at the track meet and everything. But I was just giving an update of what's going on.
This is my hot wife. You just saw her recording for Chantel's thing, but I just wanted to show her off. Look at this. Look at this, huh? Huh? Sexy, sexy, sexy.
My hair's like really fluffy today.
Yes, you look
you
great.
You see that? It's like all.
You look great, love.
Fluffy, fluffy. I'm not totally ready for the day, but that's okay.
Look at those luscious lips.
Bye. You can wave. Well, they're currently practicing for the pole vault down there. We got people flying over a non-existent bar, but I was able to meet Chantel's coach for pole vault, and he had nothing but good things to say about her progress, and he is confident that she will make it over 7 foot today. So I am crossing my fingers for her, and I am super pumped and super excited. So like I said, they're down there practicing right now. So I don't know, the meet will start soon, starting at 6 foot. And I just realized I didn't tell you what she was competing in today. So she's competing in the pole vault. She is competing in hurdles, and she is also doing a relay today. So I'm hopeful that I will be able to snag footage from all of it. So she has one at the beginning of the meet, one sort of in the middle, and then one at the end. So we're going to be here literally the whole meet.
Guess what? I just got first place.
Yay!
How high did you get?
Yeah, you got a dab in there.
Totally. 7 feet.
Booyah. Has important information. So tell us all the brand new news.
So I got talked. My coach talked to me, and she told me that I qualified to go to Medford on Saturday for pole vault. Duh! Come on, guys, I get first place. And hurdles, because I'm the fastest hurdle person they have. Anyways, so that is really cool. And because of that, because I'm going to North Medford on Saturday, they're having me switch in my uniform for a varsity uniform.
Yes, my freshman's a varsity runner now.
So I'm varsity now.
Awesome. Yeah. So, holla. So we may be heading down to Medford this weekend to watch her, which will be epic. And it's just cool. Just awesome. I don't know.